For many decades, the consequences of nuclear weapons testing were not known to the local people and to the local government. Only in the years of glasnost and perestroika, the information about the consequence of nuclear tests, or even about the very fact that the nuclear tests were conducted on such and such day, were given to the government of the Kazakh Soviet Socialist Republic. According to our government information, throughout the 40 years of Soviet nuclear weapon testing in Semipalatinsk, approximately 1.8 million people were affected. As of now, the majority of those people are dead. But now we are facing the problems with second and third generation survivors of the nuclear weapon tests. So these are children and grandchildren of those who were exposed to radiation. The tests were conducted in perhaps two big stages. One stage was on the ground and above ground. And out of 456 Soviet nuclear weapon tests at Semipalatinsk, 117 were conducted from 1949 until 1962, either on the ground or above ground. And of course, the radiation fallout and contamination from those tests was the strongest. Even though the area of the test site was 18,500 square kilometers, that's the size of the state of Delaware, the contamination with radiation was detected at an area the size of 300,000 square kilometers, and that's the size of Germany. The test site is being divided into three parts: the green zone, the yellow zone, and the red zone. There are areas of land which can be recovered, and then there are areas of land which are so contaminated that they're not to be touched for the next 24,500 years. So that's basically it in terms of the damage to the environment. In terms of the damage to the health of the people, according to various estimates, there are about 200,000 people now in Kazakhstan living in eastern Kazakhstan region, in Pavlodar region, and in Karaganda region. These are three regions which border the test site area. It is in these regions where these people are living. They are mostly affected by higher than the average rates of cancer, and they are suffering from birth defects and, of course, all kinds of other related illnesses. Given the fact that this problem is recurring, that this problem is appearing in the second and third generation of the nuclear weapons testing survivors, I think it's a challenge, not just for today, but for the foreseeable future. Thank you.